I'll take it in, but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, hey. Been holding it in for a while, hey. Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world.
Good evening, everyone. And welcome to the 2023 Spring Induction Ceremony for the Robert E. Fitch Chapter of the National Honor Society. Please stand if you are able for the singing of our national anthem.
So proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
As well as raise money for numerous scholarship funds. That being said, it is an absolute pleasure working with every single one of our members. NHS members represent the best of the best. They have the skills and character to get things done. They are truly the backbone of our school. These candidates have earned membership through the effective demonstration of the four pillars that serve as standards for the National Honor Society. Those qualities are scholarship, leadership, service, and character. I would now like to welcome Madison Porter, who will speak on the pillar of scholarship.
American poet and essayist Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "Scholarship is not to be created by compulsion, but by awakening a pure interest in knowledge." To the upcoming generation of National Honor Society members, I invite you to ask yourself, how exactly did I earn a place on this stage? The answer, your commitment to learning, otherwise defined as true scholarship. In some cases, scholarship may be distinguished as a cash reward or a mere number on a GPA scale. But your place as a scholar has been earned through the curation of knowledge. Knowledge that you will carry past the halls of Fitch High School and into the depths of your future. Your academic success up until this point has shown your true commitment to the world of learning. However, academic success in the form of a high test score or a spot at a competitive college does not define your level of scholarship. What does define your scholarship is the time, effort, and dedication you ingrained into your academics. From the long nights of studying to the research on a topic that you may not feel passionate about, you continue to put 100% into your studies. These habits were not taught, nor were they inherited, but were built through experience and the eagerness to master material. Each and every assignment you completed was one step closer to developing your personal library of knowledge. As you learn, achieve, and grow, you will realize that knowledge is the most powerful weapon you will ever have access to. Family, friends, and honored guests, these accomplished students sitting before you not only possess knowledge in academics, but in a wide variety of niches. Among our inductees, we have athletes, musicians, actors, volunteers, employees, and substantially more. Each and every one of our National Honor Society members has endured different obstacles on their path towards the acquisition of knowledge. These obstacles have propelled these individuals to gain experiences, morality, and a code of ethics. Above all, every inductee has upheld the Fitch Honor Code of honesty and integrity, which has allowed them to collectively use their knowledge to make an impact on the various communities around them. Inductees, as you emerge into further fields of academics and other niches, you will learn that knowledge is the one true skill that will never reach mastery, but it will bring you an innumerable amount of growth. If we continue to develop knowledge, gain wisdom, and acquire experience, we will continue on our path towards the highest level of scholarship. Your current dedication to learning has brought you to this moment of honor and will continue to bring you to the highest level of success. Thank you. And now Noah will speak on the pillar of leadership.
I light this candle for leadership. Congratulations to the National Honor Society inductees. You are all here because you have shown great academic leadership skills. At the top of your class, you have proved to us that you can take rigorous courses and that you have the motivation to strive for a better education. You have proven yourself worthy of a bright future. So what? Why should this matter? Academic achievement that is not applied to the real world is meaningless. You all do good deeds, as proved here by your presence tonight. But you must continue when there is no reward in sight. Whether you are the captain of a team, a leader in the classroom, or a leader in the public eye, but are not a true leader when no one is looking, then you are wasting your true talents. I want you to ask yourself, how will I be remembered through my actions and words? I recall a time when I first started fencing. We were divided starkly by our skill levels that no one took time to help the novice players improve. However, once I was no longer a novice, but a seasoned essayist, I saw the flaws in this model. It was only when I began to teach my teammates that I realized that you grow most when helping others. What if we could take this approach in other areas? When you inevitably tutor next year, think about it as an opportunity to grow. You're not only improving our Fitch High School community, but you are improving yourself. When we are forced to do something, we don't put our whole effort into it. When you volunteer, look for something that you are truly passionate about. Do not volunteer to get your 3 mandated hours of service out of the way. If you volunteer something that is meaningful, you will be driven to do your best. You will be more successful and beneficial to others. You must look to your community and use this wonderful gift of an education that it has given you in order to give back to it. Go out into the public and make a better world. Today, our society needs this lesson. Everyone cares for themselves, but not for others. You can make that change. I challenge the upcoming National Honor Society class to lead only for the benefits of others. Volunteer more than 3 hours a month. Become a captain or president of a club so you can improve upon the members, not so you can write it down in a college resume. Tutor for the success of your fellow classmate. Put the well-being of the majority of the people before yourself and let them lead you. And maybe, just then, you will be a true leader. Thank you. And now Rihanna will speak on the pillar of service.
Firstly, let me begin by congratulating all of our new inductees. Tonight, we join together to celebrate your scholarly achievements and commitment to serving others. You should all be proud of yourselves. The National Honor Society was founded on 4 pillars: character, scholarship, citizenship, and service. Although all 4 pillars are necessary to becoming a strong leader, I believe the most unique of the 4 is service. While the other 3 pillars have to do with bettering your own being, service allows for an individual to better the community surrounding them. In fact, that's exactly the reason I believe service is the most important of these 4 qualities. Now, what exactly is service? To me, service is more than something to look good on your resume. It's more than begrudgingly helping family or friends when they ask for it. It's more than fulfilling your hourly requirements to stay in good standings in the NHS. All of the reasons I listed are quite the opposite of service, in fact, because even though you are technically providing community service, there's an underlying tone of selfishness. Service, to me, means completely giving up that selfishness in order to truly better society. As Maya Angelou once said, I have found that among its other benefits, giving liberates the soul of the giver. By bettering society and choosing to become selfless, you are inherently bettering yourself and becoming more of a leader. About a year ago, when I was in your shoes, I didn't do much to serve my community. I mean, I took up volunteering opportunities for the school, but none of that service was truly selfless. It was all an obligation. It wasn't until I started tutoring my peers or volunteering at places I was passionate about, like the Guard Arts Theater, that I finally let go. The services I started doing this year truly improved our community. Instead of feeling this obligation to do good deeds, I found myself enjoying the service I was doing. And I enjoyed it because it wasn't an obligation. Starting today, I challenge all of you on this stage with me to find that one service you are truly passionate about and give it your all over the following year. Make it a habit to give back to your community every day and do so without looking for ways it benefits you. If each and every one of you incorporates more service into your life every day, who knows how our community will progress? Dr. Martin Luther King said it best. Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Thank you. And now, Katie will speak on the pillar of character.
I light this candle for character.
John Wooden, a famous basketball coach for the UCLA Bruins, once said to his team, "The true test of someone's character is what one does when no one is watching." The first time I heard this quote, it hit me like a ton of bricks. I marveled at the fact of how incredibly true it was. To my parents and teachers, I'm a hardworking, God-loving, motivated, and sometimes grade-obsessed young adult ready to take on the world. To my boyfriend and friends, I'm an outgoing, fun-loving, caring, and independent person. But who am I when it's just me? I believe that's a choice I get to make when I wake up every day. But now the choice is yours. Who do you want to be today? Are you going to choose to dwell on the good or on the bad? Do you want to work hard or let the day pass you by? Will you become a role model or behave irresponsibly? As students that have been chosen to be inducted into the National Honor Society, it is important to fix your mind on the good, to work hard, and to become role models. Inductees, I believe each of you has the qualities of a National Honor Society member. And it is essential that you continue to exhibit those qualities as you progress through your senior year as members of the National Honor Society. Though there will be hard days, busy seasons, daily challenges, it is vital that you never cease displaying the dedication, effort, and passion you all have as students selected to be in such a group. I believe that irrespective of your reputation, what may come of someone's opinion of you, or their take on who or what you should be, it is your character that will be remembered. Wooden also said, "Be more concerned with your character than your reputation, because your character is what you really are, while your reputation is merely what others think you are." As a member of the National Honor Society, it is important to dwell on the good, to make the choice to work hard, and to be role models in front of students. The choice may not always be easy, and the trials you face may not always have a simple answer, but I ask you all to choose good for others and to choose good for yourselves. Whether it's all eyes on you or just time by yourself, make the choice to do good. Thank you.
I would like to introduce Assistant Superintendent Dr. Piazza and our principal, Mr. Kelleher, who will be awarding certificates and membership pins. Please hold all applause until all students are called, but you can applaud for them. Kaylee Allen. Gabriella Amaral. Zoe Antipas. Miles Appleby.
Get Miles!
Wow, get it, Miles!
Isabel Asciola.
Woo!
Jack Berry. Elena Brookhart. Sophia Cabral. Nicole Cardona Navarro. Aiden Choi. Estelle Connell. Matthew Deichler. Gianni Drab. Lily Drake. Charlotte Driscoll. Morgan Fisher. Juliet Georges. Tate Gordon. Riley Harrington. Brianna Harris. Meredith Holtmeyer. Maria Teresa Morgan. Kylie Jenkins. Catherine Lamb. Calvin McCoy III. Logan Meenan. Eleanor Menez. Jeffrey Muse. Julia Mielboy. Erica Nicklin.
Oh, yeah.
Pia Louise Nicholas. Annalise Otano.
Woo! Hey, pumpkin! Sophia Pacheco.
Let's go!
Sakhi Patel. Sean Reddy. Catherine Regan. Colin Riley. Jillian Riley. Andres Sardar. Annabelle Schaefer. Fizza Sharif. Drayana Singleton. Nicholas Sousa. Dante Valentine. Nathan Virtue.
Hold it up.
Jonathan White. Mason Woodhams. There were two candidates who were not able to come tonight. I just wanted to acknowledge them and recognize them. They were Bowden Frost and Catherine McKenna. Please join me in congratulating our candidates. Rihanna will now deliver the oath of membership.
Inductees, please take out your candles. Please stand and raise your right hand. Repeat after me. I pledge myself to uphold the highest purposes of the National Honor Society.
To which I have been selected.
I will be true to the principles for which it stands. I will be loyal to my school. And I will maintain and encourage high standards. Of scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Congratulations, you are now officially members of the National Honor Society. I would now like to introduce our guest speaker tonight, Ms. Carmita Hodge, Assistant Principal at Fitch High School. Ms. Hodge received both her Bachelor's in Political Science and Master of Education at Howard University. After teaching in the District of Columbia Public School System, Ms. Hodge returned to Connecticut as a special education teacher in the Groton Public School System. During her many years in the Groton Public School System, she's fulfilled many roles, including social studies teacher, social studies department head, 6th through 12th humanities coordinator, and now an assistant principal. She reminds students that hard work is a necessary condition for success, despite the challenges and obstacles one may face. Please welcome Ms. Carmita Hodge.
Lucky to be speaking to the inductees of the National Honor Society this year. I see you all. I see you all. You make me proud. And thank you for coming, everyone. Thank you for being here. First, I want to thank Mr. Dunn and the National Honor Society Faculty Board and officers for inviting me to be here and speak to the inductees. This is a real treat for me. But since I'm going to be speaking directly to the inductees, I'm going to turn this pulpit around because I have a message for you. Okay? All right, so after contemplating on how I'm going to do this and what I'm going to do, I thought about presenting slides, which are on stage. I thought about doing a play, singing, doing something different, just to make sure that I get your attention and you receive the message I have for you today. So after all of that, I thought about something that would be personal, something that you would remember. And so I wrote a letter to you. So here we go. Dear National Honor Society inductees, many of you have heard me in the classroom, on the hallways, offering extemporaneous advice wrapped in quoted nuggets of wisdom. For example, you know I've seen you, if I've seen you in the hallway, you might have heard me say, you can't get a good education in the hallways. You know that? But then again, you don't roam the hallways, right? You're in class. Right, Morgan? You're in class. Morgan's shaking her head. Right? You're in class. You're sitting in class, you're on time, right? Or you may have heard me say, and I borrowed this one from my mother, everyone is busy, but you do what is important to you. When I would hear, we make excuses for not completing an assignment or following through with a task, but again, you all complete all your homework, you complete it on time, and you turn it in. Then I heard this quote posted on my classroom door. You may have seen it before. And it was mentioned in my introduction. Hard work is a necessary condition for success. Hard work is a necessary condition for success. There is so much I can say about the quote, but let's be honest. You know the value of hard work because you're being inducted into one of the most celebrated organizations tonight. While writing this letter to you, I'm reminded of also the National Honor Society tenets, and we've been going through them and repeating them throughout the night. But I've witnessed many of you exhibit them in your lives, in the school community, and in your school environment. Just to remind you again of the four tenets, the first one is creating enthusiasm for scholarship. The second one is stimulating the desire to render service within the school and the community. The third one, promoting worthy leadership. And the last is encouraging the development of the highest level of character. I know you are more than familiar with the tenets, and for the rest of your lives, you will adhere to the tenets. The first tenet encourages you to create enthusiasm for scholarship. So story time. When I was in the fourth grade, there were two things I knew for sure. I knew that I was going to attend Howard University, and then I wanted to study business. Guess which one happened for sure? Which one? I went to Howard. Exactly. I attended Howard. As a matter of fact, I did begin in the School of Business, but then switched my major, earning the political science degree, with the hope of studying law. I even went to Georgetown pre-law school. but I changed my mind. I went to Howard University, and then, after studying political science and then pre-law at Georgetown, I ended up getting a master's in education. So I walked into the Howard, took a few detours, and arrived at a profession I was called to do. So nugget number one, don't be surprised if the major you decide to study in your first year of college may not be the degree you walk across the stage to accept. Don't be surprised or dismayed when you enter the working world and you find yourself even studying a different degree or earning a different degree or building a business. Pursuing a different path does not equate to setbacks, but it does equate to opportunities. Opportunities to explore options, develop your skills and interests. The vision of your life will change as you mature in your daily living. At the end of the day, please know that it's still okay, even if you don't start where you end. The next tenet falls in line with two prolific quotes I'd like to share. Rihanna already mentioned one, Dr. King, right? Martin Luther King scholar. Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? And for those of you who are Swifties, Taylor Swift said, if you think that your day is hard, try living in somebody else's life. That's what volunteering has done for me, per Taylor Swift. So nugget number two, stimulating the desire to render service within the school and the community begs the question, what are you doing for others? Our life is about living our best lives and presenting ourselves as the best versions in service. Although my title is assistant principal, I am often charged with serving on many other platforms. When I taught at the elementary level, I was a student mentor. When I taught at the level of the middle school, I was a spelling bee advisor. And now at the high school, I'm the BSU, or the Black Student Advisor, all volunteer because it's something that I was passionate about. At my church, I served as a pianist. And in the community, I served on the board of the Martin Luther King Scholarship. Again, everything that I did because it was passion. So I implore you to continue to serve others, not for the shine or for the prize, but for the honor of doing so. Although promoting worthy leadership in National Honor Society is a third tenet, it is the most exciting and complicated at the same time. When I asked a few people how they define leadership, I heard many identifiers. Some said it was the boss. Others call it the head honcho. Others said it was the person in charge. Throughout the years, I've learned and recognized that leadership goes beyond the scope of telling people what to do. Based on what I know and what I've observed, leadership shows up in how you support others, how you show respect to your classmates, your teachers, your administrators, your parents, and how you model justice, grace, and mercy. So nugget number three, take the time to get to know yourself, your talents, and your gifts. Get to know your strengths and how to utilize them and understand, and seek support in areas where you fall a little short. Look beyond the scope of telling people what to do and operate as a leader through your words, actions, and intent. As you experience life and mature, your character will develop a constant need for knowledge, a need to serve, and a need to appreciate who you are and how you show up for the world. Don't be surprised that your volunteering and your serving in the community don't become something that is a goal and a passion that you will always continue to do for the rest of your life. Last and most definitely not least, NHS Last 10 speaks about character. It's development for all, on all platforms. So what is it? Character is what shows up for a task, a job, or a crisis when no one is looking. It even tends to show up in the room way before you arrive. It can be the best version of you, and it can be the worst part of your reputation that people remember. So I encourage you, let your reputation precede you. So question, When your name is called, what words would follow? How will people remember you? What is being said about you today? How do you want to be remembered? So nugget number four, let's be clear. There will be times where you be challenged by people, places, and things that will lead us to the crossroads of retaliation, unfortunately, but favor, nevertheless. But our disposition, temperament, and demeanor will allow us to choose service and grace. A wise woman, my sister, really, once told me, your resume will only tell people the places you have been, but your character will show them your grace, your glow, and your gifts. Respect and protect your character. Respect and protect your character. Tonight is indeed a special night for you and your families. As a matter of fact, I'm sure tonight will be the beginning of many other rewarding sessions and seasons that you'll have in your lifetime. As you continue to experience, learn, and grow in every one of your seasons, I encourage you to live by the tenets set by the NHS and call on them as you experience life's ups and downs. Keep them close to your heart as you build space in this big old world. And as I close this letter, I think about who shows up for you every day and who showed up for you on this special day. On behalf of the school community, we are so proud of you, so proud of you. We honor you. We honor who you are, and we are excited to witness all you will do and all you will become. Congratulations and thank you.
This concludes tonight's induction ceremony. I would like to extend one last congratulations to our new members of the National Honor Society. A sincere thank you to Principal Kelleher, Dr. Piazza, Ms. Hodge, and all our administrators and board members for making tonight such a success. Have a great evening.
I'm on top of the world, hey.